Quick question. How many eigenvectors are there? If I had more than D images, okay, so D 10,000 dimension, let's say, or a million. So if I had, you know, 10,000 images and I was looking at all those, I could get 10,000 eigenvectors. But clearly, the sum of those outer products, if I've only got a small number, right, the whole idea is that M is going to be a lot less than D. So how many of them are there? Well, your intuition might say, well, I've got M independent things, so there must be M of them. But actually, your intuition was wrong. And in fact, a better intuition would be the following. Suppose I gave you 2 points in 3 dimensions, okay? How many vectors can span those? Just one, right? I go between them. And the reason is I have to think about subtracting off the mean, right? And once I subtract off the mean, actually, I only have 1 degree of freedom, right? Because the origin is going to be halfway between those 2 points. So once you tell me where one of the points is, I know where the other one is. So there's only 1 degree of freedom. So with 2 points, there's only 1 possible eigenvector. Let's think about it this way. If I have 3 points in space, okay, how many vectors does it take to span those points? Well, they lie in a plane, don't they? Of course they do. 3 points defines a triangle. So with 3 points, there's only 2 eigenvectors. In general, there are m minus 1 eigenvectors. And the reason there's m minus 1 is I take my m points and I subtract out the mean, so that removes a degree of freedom. So that's a trick question that I always give on the final of my course. So if anybody's taking the final, now you know the answer. Okay, there's m minus 1.